Looks like we're in the right place.
Well, that's ominous.
This is a massacre.
Crimson Lance, these guys are serious badasses.
Watch your step. Whole place could be booby-trapped. If this place is as valuable as we think it is, they might be trying to protect it.
I don't see any signs of sensors or tripwires or anything like that. But still, you might be right.
Booby traps? Are you serious? This isn't some ancient temple or something. It's just an Atlas facility.
A top secret one. That we needed to find a hidden entrance for?
Okay, that's a valid point.
This is Athena's handiwork. Starting to think we might have just gotten lucky with her back there.
Mr. $10 million.
Recent Bond's new little playmates, right? It's very good to meet the two of you. It's a shame we couldn't be meeting under different circumstances. Bond? Reese? You didn't think I'd have August handling all my dirty work, did you? There are some things a man just does himself.
How the hell do you keep showing up? We've escaped you like a gajillion times now.
Reese. Only the fool thinks that he escapes his shadow in darkness.
What? Loaderbot! Arm weapons or something!
I'm helping!
Come on, guys. You didn't think I'd come all the way down here before grabbing a universal remote, did you?
What?
The Gordis Project, the two halves of the core, everything leading to a vault. We got it.
Checkmate, amigos.
I am shame.
What'd you think, Reese? That you could pilfer something from my toy box, no strings attached?
You never could follow through. That's your problem.
And that's why I beat you every time.
Oh, your payback's coming, asshole. I don't know how, I don't know when, but you're gonna make a mistake. And when you do, I'll be there.
Sure. I'll bring flowers.
Yeah, you'll bring flowers. What?
To your grave, because you'll be dead.
Oh, you guys cannot believe the dream I just had. Holy crap.
Wait. What the hell is this? Didn't I just do this with this guy? Kiddo, I admire your consistency, but, God. Oh, and who is this princess?
Wait, they...
Son of a...
Shock, other people.
Oh, yes, I knew about that. Don't touch the cores, August.
Thanks for the heads up. Jackass.
They're gonna have to do it for us. You'll cooperate, right? Because I figure if you don't, well, I can think of all sorts of things to do to your little friends.
It sounds like we don't exactly have a choice, now do we?
That's the spirit.
Two hallways, two halves.
I'll take my soon-to-be-dead janitor here. You take Miss Fancy Hat down the other one.
Boys, you keep an eye on these two. Especially this one. Don't believe a thing she says.
Oh, how sweet.
Yeah, you sit tight.
Get your hands off me!
Either of those two move, you shoot them where they stand. Reese, I'll admit it, you and Vaughn have impressed me, and that sort of thing doesn't happen often. I'm surprised you've made it this far.
Hugo Vasquez, Hugo Vasquez. There's something I remember about this guy. What the hell
really?
Is it?
Really? It's unbelievable.
He must have had some sort of help.
Couple of death jockeys like you. I'd say it was 50-50. It survived the landing.
I got help from Handsome Jack.
Oh, so we're telling everyone now. Is that what we're doing?
Ah, yeah. Well, I totally get what you're saying there. I, too, have found Handsome Jack to be an eternal well of inspiration. I mean, you might think of me as a self-made man, and for the most part, you'd be right. But there was this time when I looked up and admired one man in particular. The most impressive person
I've ever known. He's gonna say me.
Handsome Jack.
You idiots always say me. Still can't figure out who he is, though.
We had this special rapport. He would do this thing where he would punch me in the face whenever he'd see me. It didn't matter if he was busy. He always made time for me.
No, still nothing. I punched my mom, for Christ's sake.
Just boom, right in the kisser. I was drinking from a mug when he got me one time. Chipped a molar.
I hate to break it to you, Vasquez, but what you're describing
is... You don't get it. You don't get it. You don't. The point is, I was his punching bag.
Oh, man. He thought we were exclusive. That's adorable.
I miss our time together.
Ah, this drives me crazy. It's right there. It's on the tip of my tongue.
But through me, his legacy carries on.
How did you get paired up with an asshole like Vasquez?
No, he's not so bad. He's just a little dumb. Valerie, the woman I work for, she's got a lot of contacts up on Hyperion, Vasquez being one of them. Problem is, we tried to cut her out of the deal. Obviously, that was a bad idea for a lot of reasons. The fact that the vault key was bullshit being first and foremost. Well, Valerie found out about it, so now we've got to convince her that whatever comes out of this room is worth more than the $10 million deal we tried to slip under her nose. Then, hopefully, she doesn't kill us all. She ever talk about me?
What?
Sasha, did she ever talk about me? You guys are sisters. I figure you'd talk every now and again. Just curious if she ever mentioned me.
Nope, not once.
Huh, that's a little disappointing. Look, I just want you to know, as far as you and I are concerned, there's no hard feelings.
That is so generous of you. I'll think about that when you shoot me in the back.
Come on, don't be like that. You're the one that hustled me, remember?
And that, you see, is what I was trying to provide for you. Some guidance, some mentorship, a father figure. I was trying to help you. The janitor gig, it was to test your mettle, your resolve. And I gotta say, you reacted with some balls, kid. Some big old balls. You see, Reese, I started at the bottom, and I worked my way up. I used to be in the mailroom.
Whoa, wait a minute. Wallet head!
That's where Jack found me.
He used to be bald and he was going through these hair implants and would stick money to his head. It was hilarious. But it was a long time ago. Ask him about it. He'll tell you. Ask him about it. Go on, seriously.
But that's a pretty big difference.
Hey, come on, I'm handing you comedy gold here. What, are you gonna ignore this?
Listen, Wallethead.
Wallethead?
Yeah, so I appreciate the advice. I do. But I'd much rather you take your 2 cents and shove them into your wallet that you have on the back of your head that you are ashamed of because you are a Wallethead.
I was trying to be nice to you. Let's get this over with.
Oh, that's good.
When I take your corpse back up to Helios, I'm gonna make sure they save me some of your skin to make a wallet out of. Whenever I see it, I'll remember the look on your face at this moment. Whoa. That's legitimately creepy. I can't tell you how much I'm looking forward to getting back to Helios, Reese. This place, it's getting to me. It's the smell. No! Hey! Hey!
I just need some reassurances. That it was just about the money and nothing else. And relationships have to be built on trust. I don't know if I can take Sasha back without it.
How do you even start a conversation like that? At this point, I assume she's just embarrassed.
August, you're pathetic.
So you're saying I shouldn't take her back? Hey, we all make mistakes. I've certainly made my fair share. Who am I to judge?
You're pathetic.
Yeah, I heard you the first time. Well, here we are. Go on. Stalling won't do you any good.
Come on, are you stalling? I don't know if you've gotten the impression that I'm the kind of guy who likes being dicked around, but I'm really not. What is this? No. No, 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 no!
Have a nice chat?
I can't imagine he's too happy with you guys.
At least that's the vibe I was getting.
I hate that son of a bitch.
I kind of picked up on that.
Gortys unit ready for assembly.
We got it! We got it!
I guess that's our cue.
Do you think I'm doing?
What the hell is that?
That is a metal ball.
How's this gonna get us into a vault?
Maybe it's some sort of vault key.
It doesn't look like any vault key I've seen.
Oh please, the only vault key you've seen was the fake one you tried to sell me.
This is true. Grab the thing and let's go. No, 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 what are you doing?
Warning, Gortis device compromised.
Smooth one, idiot.
It's fine, it's fine. See?
Uh-oh. Didn't like that, Reese. Did not like that one bit.
No problem. Everything is okay.
Trust me. Back off!
Whoa, 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 what's she doing? This isn't good, this is bad. Reese, you gotta let me into your subsystems, man. I can hack into these drones and I can almost guarantee no one dies. Unless you want them to, probably. Just let me in.
Under controllers. Trust me.
What? No, no. Listen, we can take over the whole facility, kid. We got this.
Okay.
Okay, what? Are you talking to me?
Yes, yes, I'm talking to you. Do whatever it is you have to do.
How are you doing that?
I'm not. Really.
Hail to the king, baby!
Boah, okay. Das war Episode 2. Ja. Jo. Pff, jo. Also so krass fand ich die jetzt ehrlich gesagt nicht. Ja, also von den Charakteren her schon klar. Scooter war mit drin. Wer war noch mit drin? Athena war natürlich mit drin. Wir haben jetzt erfahren, dass Brick in der nächsten Episode vorkommt. Ich warte immer noch auf den großen Auftritt. Vom Only One King. Vom besten fucking Charakter im ganzen Borderlands-Universum. Mr. Mordecai. Ne, da warte ich immer noch drauf. Aber ja. Nun. Wir hatten uns wieder entschieden. Bei Fiona war es so, dass 80,1% der Spieler genauso wie ich gesagt haben, okay, Sascha, helf Reese. Okay, das hat anscheinend wirklich großartig was ausgemacht, hätte ich nicht gedacht. Aber es hat funktioniert. Ich habe wenigstens einigermaßen geschafft, dass ich größtenteils Sachen ausgewählt habe, die andere Spieler nicht ausgewählt haben. Ja, ich habe mich zusammen mit 11% aller Spieler dagegen entschieden, mein Auto aufzumotzen, weil ich einfach zu lange gebraucht habe für die Scheiße. Naja, wie gesagt, ich hoffe, das bereuen wir nicht, aber dadurch haben wir natürlich auch eine Menge Geld gespart, beziehungsweise haben jetzt $1000, die wir vielleicht in der nächsten Episode durch was wirklich Sinnvolles eintauschen können. 18,3% der Player Peaked Inside Saschas Gift. Ja gut, das macht natürlich kein Mensch mit einem normalen moralischen oder Denken, der jetzt wirklich sagt, okay, ich bin ein ehrlicher Mensch, bla bla bla, ich gebe ihr das Kästchen geschlossen. Nein, ich bin natürlich ein Arschgesicht, deswegen gucke ich auch dementsprechend rein. Finch, wer war nochmal Finch? Finch, war das dieser eine Bandit? Ich glaube schon. 36,1% haben ihn mit Feuer angegriffen. Was ich sehr cool fand als Reaktion. Weißt du, vorher noch dieses Kommentar zu seinen Haaren und dann fackeln die Haare so ab. Das war irgendwie voll asozial. Okay, oder es war das in der Bar, wo ich den einen Typ, ich weiß gar nicht, ob der Finch hieß oder der Bandit so Finch hieß. Also dieser, dieser Typ, der die Bar beschützt, dieser Türsteher, da konnte man sich ja ausruhen, ob man die Flasche nimmt oder das Messer. Das war eigentlich ja auch noch eine Entscheidung, aber okay, war anscheinend irgendwie scheißegal. Okay, bei Reese, you and 18,2% of players keep handsome Jack a secret. Ach so, ja, ich habe Handsome Jack geheim gehalten gegenüber meinen Kumpels, weil ich finde, dass ich mit Handsome Jacks Hilfe noch einiges erreichen kann. Und dementsprechend geht das auch niemandem was an, dass der die ganze Zeit neben mir rennt. Und da habe ich tatsächlich mich mehrheitlich entschieden. Das hätte ich nicht gedacht. Ich hätte gedacht, die meisten Leute wollten nach New Haven, nach Old Haven zuerst gehen. Und nicht nach Hollow Point. Okay, das hat mich jetzt überrascht. Okay, 91,1% haben One gebrofistet. Das war einfach ein cooler Dialog. Okay, da konnte ich einfach nicht anders. Ich musste ihn brofisten. Das war. Und nur 34,1% aller Spieler haben Jack vertraut. Also ich habe wieder mal mein Ziel erreicht, größtenteils nicht so zu denken, wie jeder denkt, und habe tatsächlich größtenteils meine Entscheidungen wirklich ziemlich gut gewählt, muss ich sagen. Also ich versuche ja quasi, mich auch von den Leuten abzuheben, so wie Patze, die das schon durchhaben und gerne gewusst hätten, was bei den anderen Entscheidungen passiert. Bin mal gespannt. Also Patze, du kannst ja jetzt mal so in dir die Kommentare ein bisschen schreiben, was quasi bei dir an den betreffenden Stellen passiert ist. Das würde mich mal wirklich interessieren, ob ich da großartig was verpasst habe oder ob großartig was anders ist. Ist das hier noch so ein Fazit? When time is limited and enemies are not, sometimes it's necessary to either divide your crew or stand your ground. Okay. Bin ich, also die krasseste Entscheidung war wohl einfach, dass ich mein Fahrzeug nicht aufgemotzt habe. Das hat fast gar keiner gemacht. Ja, das werde ich noch bereuen. Ich sehe es jetzt schon kommen. Okay. Kommt jetzt noch was? Nö, wahrscheinlich komme ich jetzt einfach wieder ins Menü, ja. Ach so, klar. Die Credits noch mit einem coolen Endsong. Dann stelle ich jetzt nochmal mein Mikrofon auf Stumm, weil das Lied ist ziemlich cool, bis die Credits zu Ende sind. Und sage einfach, bis zum nächsten Mal, wenn die Tales from Borderlands wieder fortgesetzt werden hier auf der Zocker-Crew. Ja, bis denn.